the opportunity to travel anywhere in the world for free. Like, I didn't have to pay for anything, no flights or accommodation, food, everything's all paid for. I was tossing up between Europe or Asia, and I think I've settled on Asia because I really want to visit South Korea. I learned to speak Korean when I was 16, and I was watching all the movies and dramas and listening to the music, and I would go to Korean restaurants and order all the food and just fell in love with the culture, and I've never actually had a chance to go. So I think that's one place I would definitely go to see everyone, because the people are so friendly. And then I would definitely go to Japan as well, because it's close by. And then, yeah, I think it would be a really great trip just to tour East Asia and see everything there. And it'd be really cool because it would be free as well. So that would be awesome.
네, 오늘 영상 속에 나왔던 핵심 문장 3개 복습해 보겠습니다. 첫 번째, I was tossing up between Europe and Europe or Asia라고 했는데 Europe and Asia라고 해도 마찬가지입니다. 그래서 toss up이라는 것이 동전 던지기로 결정하다는 뜻이지만 I was tossing up between 뭐뭐 A and B 이렇게 해도 그냥 고민 중이었다라는 뜻이 된다는 거 꼭 기억해 주시고요. 여기서는 이제 조금 특이하게 or가 쓰였습니다. 발음 연습해 볼까요?
Repeat after me. I was tossing up between Europe or Asia. I was tossing up between Europe or Asia. Let's look at the next one.
16살 때 한국어를 배웠어요라는 문장이 나왔었어요. I learned to speak Korean when I was 16이었는데요. 우리가 언어를 배울 때 그냥 I learned English라고, I learned Korean이라고 말을 하는 경우도 있지만 learn to speak, 말하는 게 제일 중요하잖아요. 그래서 한국어를 하는 방법, 말하는 방법을 배웠다라고 해서 이런 형태 많이 씁니다. I learned to speak Korean. 한번 발음 연습해 볼까요?
I learned to speak Korean when I was 16. I learned to speak Korean when I was 16. Let's look at the last one.
그런데 한 번도 실제로 가볼 기회가 없었습니다라는 문장이 나와요. I've never actually had a chance to go. I've never actually had a chance to go. 여러 가지 요소가 있어요. I've never, 그 다음에 actually had a chance to go. 쭉 이어서 발음 연습해 보겠습니다.
I've never actually had a chance to go. I've never actually had a chance to go. Okay, since we've gone over those key sentences, let's move on to today's pattern practice.
네, 여러분, 오늘의 핵심 패턴입니다. 저는 뭐뭐로 마음이 정해진 것 같아요. 뭐뭐로 마음이 기운 것 같아요. 라고 말하고 싶을 때 I think I've settled on 뭐뭐뭐 이어주시면 되겠습니다. I think I've settled on something. 어떤 예문들이 가능한지 한번 볼까요? I think I've settled on something. I think I've settled on something. I think I've settled on something.
I think I've settled on South Korea. I think I've settled on South Korea.
네, 본문에 나온 이야기였죠. 이 문장이었죠. 그다음 두 번째, 저는 오늘 저녁에 입을 옷을 결정한 것 같아요.
In English, that is, I think I've settled on an outfit for this evening.
Yeah. Settle on outfit 하면 옷 위에 정착하다 이상하죠.
Yeah. 네,
진짜 settle down on something 이런 느낌이 아니고 settle on.
Yes.
You've decided on something.
Yes, you've decided or you've chosen.
네, 결정 또는 골랐다는 뜻입니다. 선택했다는 뜻입니다. Mm-hmm. I think I've settled on an outfit for this evening. Mm-hmm. 그다음 마지막으로 여러 번 상의한 끝에 우리는 드디어 합의점을 찾은 것 같아요.
After many discussions, I think we finally settled on an agreement.
네, 마음이 안 맞았다가 이제 이쪽으로 같이 하나의 agreement로 정해진 겁니다. 그래서 합의점을 찾은 것 같아요. I think we have finally settled on an agreement. 이렇게 바꿀 수 있다는 거 꼭 기억해 주시면 좋겠습니다.
Since we've gone over those, how about we review and look at the clip once again, but this time with both Korean and English subtitles.
If I the opportunity to travel anywhere in the world for free, like I didn't have to pay for anything, no flights or accommodation, food, everything's all paid for. I was tossing up between Europe or Asia, and I think I've settled on Asia because I really want to visit South Korea. I learned to speak Korean when I was 16, and I was watching all the movies and dramas and listening to the music, and I would go to Korean restaurants and order all the food and just fell in love with the culture, and I've never actually had a chance to go. So I think that's one place I would definitely go to see everyone because the people are so friendly. And then I would definitely go to Japan as well because it's close by. And then, yeah, I think it would be a really great trip just to tour East Asia and see everything there. And it'd be really cool because it would be free as well. So that would be awesome.
오늘의 알쏭달쏭 한마디 소개하겠습니다. 오늘 영어로 바꿔볼 표현은요, 바로 모든 경비는 회사에서 지불할 겁니다. 이거 영어로 어떻게 말할까요?
In English, that would be everything will be paid for by the company.
네, 모든 것은 지불이 될 겁니다. 지불의 대상이 될 겁니다. Will be paid가 아니고요. Will be paid for까지 꼭 쓰셔야 됩니다. Mm-hmm. Everything will be paid for. Pay 다음에 바로 나오는 것은 pay money.
Yeah.
Money will be paid.
Of course, there will be money paid.
네, everything will be paid for by the company. 한번 읽어볼까요, 다시?
Everything will be paid for by the company.
네, 마지막으로 한번 제가 읽어볼게요. Everything will be paid for by the company. 꼭 기억해 주세요.
All right, since we've done that, how about we move on to In the Social World.
Yeah, 네, 사람들이 어디든지 갈 수 있다면 어디를 가고 싶다고 올려줬는지 mm-hmm. 소셜 미디어 포스팅 두 개 보겠습니다.
If I could go anywhere, I would have a hard time choosing, but it would have to be a place where they have coffee and internet. I really want to visit Southern Australia to visit the place where my mum was born. It would be amazing to see and experience the culture and scenery of my mother's heritage.
자, 첫 번째 포스팅은 리네아 씨가 올려주신 것 같은데요. 리네아.
If I could go anywhere, I would have a hard time choosing, but it would have to be a place where they have coffee and internet.
어디든지 갈 수 있다면, if I could go anywhere, I would have a hard time choosing. Mm-hmm. 결정하는데에 먹을 것 같아요. 결정하기 mm-hmm. 어려울 것 같아요. 근데 간다면 it would have to be a place 어떤 장소여야 되냐면 where they have coffee and internet. Basically most cities around the world.
Yeah, I was like that's 네, basically anywhere.
도시라면 다 이제 이 조건이 coffee. 충족되는 것 같은데요.
Okay.
Yeah, as long as you're not in the mountains or
right.
Yeah, in the ocean like on the ocean.
True.
You can meet this requirement.
Uh-huh. The next one was posted by Joshua. Mm-hmm. I really want to visit Southern Australia to visit the place where my mum was born. It would be amazing to see and experience the culture and scenery of my mother's heritage.
네. Southern Australia. 남부, 호주 남부, 남호주를 정말 가보고 싶대요. To visit the place where my mom이 아니고 mum. 호주, 영국에서는 이제 mum이라고 많이 하죠.
Mom.
엄마가 태어나신 곳을 가보고 싶기 때문에 이제 가보려고 남호주를 꼭 가보고 싶고요. It would be amazing to see and experience 보고 또 경험하는 것이 정말 좋을 것 같습니다. The culture, 문화 and the scenery, 경치죠. Of my mother's heritage. Heritage라는 것은 물려받은 거, 유산 같은 걸 말해요. Cultural heritage, 문화유산이죠.
Yeah.
네, 또 누군가의 뿌리를 말하기도 합니다. 그래서 mm-hmm. 엄마의 고향의 문화와
yes.
경치를 보면 좋을 것 같다라는 포스팅이었습니다.
Mm-hmm. Well, perfect. That's the end of In the Social World for today. Mm-hmm. Make sure you visit us online and let us know where you would want to go if you could go anywhere for free.
Yeah, one time.
Not two times.
Okay, two times is fine too.
Perfect. And we'll see you next time.
다음 시간에 뵙겠습니다. Bye-bye.